everybody. This is Kiefer from DangerouslyHardcore.com with another TubeCast for you. And there's a lot of questions out there about glycemic index, the insulin index, and these large insulin spikes that you're getting towards the end of the day. And there's some health concerns, and also some people are massively screwing up the diet by trying to use low glycemic foods, thinking that for some reason the low glycemic foods are healthy. Low glycemic foods in general are not healthy compared to high glycemic foods. And let me tell you why. First of all, there's a threshold of negative effects of insulin, and that happens with actually low glycemic foods. What they do is they peak insulin levels just high enough to prevent fat cells from releasing fat, but allowing fat cells to really soak it in. Now, if you push insulin levels really high with a high glycemic food index, turns out if you cross a certain threshold, then all of a sudden insulin actually triggers fat cells to release more fat. This is one reason that people fail miserably, as I mentioned before, when they try to carb backload or carb night on low glycemic foods. You will fail, end of story, and it's because you're missing out on the very beneficial fat burning properties of insulin, or lipolytic properties. It will affect fat burning, but we're doing it at the end of the night. We're getting a quick spike. We don't want those insulin levels to go through the night. We're getting a quick spike, we're getting them up. And then as the evening progresses, you'll burn fat through the evening. So what you've done is released more fat into your system for your body to dispose of. That's one of the great advantages of high glycemic foods. Now, from a health perspective, there's not a lot of data or research yet, although studies are showing that it is healthier to have your carbs at night, period. It increases insulin sensitivity, it increases all the parameters that we associate with health, C-reactive protein, body fat levels, muscle composition. So it is advantage. And people who have been doing their blood work while on carb backloading have actually gotten healthier as the process has gone on. So right now there's not enough research to confirm or deny what the potential health risks or benefits are, but so far all the research is pointing to nothing but benefit. All right, that's another tip from dangerouslyhardcore.com.